Serious business on a Friday night. Good evening, everybody. This is where the rubber hits the road, you might say. Most Kansas high school basketball clubs, including Bishop Miege, are playing their final regular season games on a Friday night. Let's get to the action. Bishop Miege begins the night with a chance to seal up the EKL championship. Their final regular season game brings in Blue Valley West. Miege led 22-18 at the halftime break. Spencer Jones is a sight to be seen. One of the three seniors in the starting lineup. He gets the nice baseline J. The Stags would lead by 9. West is not a bad team. Greg Riddle, not a bad player. This isn't a bad move. In fact, it's pretty good. Two of his dozen still in the third, and Rick Zeke's club lights the fire. Watch this. Jones on the break. Give him the ball. He gives it to the rim. 13 for him. Miege's lead grows to a dozen, and Josh Early led the Stags with 15 strong ones. Part of a 58-33 victory. The 4A champs lock up the EKL, and they're ready for tourney time.
Our goal is to win the state championship. We won three in a row, and it's going to be a tough road, but that's our next goal starting on Wednesday. I think we share the ball real well. They're great teammates. They work real hard. They let us coach them, and the sky's the limit.
The East may have found momentum at the right time. The Hawks have won 6 of their last 9 games as they visit Shawnee Mission North. This is pretty good action from the Shawnee Mission School District in the opening moments. The Hawks begin the game as birds of prey. Kamari Armstrong popping the 3. East had that shot anytime they wanted in the first half. Moments later, Robert Kohlberg proves the break isn't broken, part of a 7-0 start for Olathe East on the road. The Indians, well-coached and athletic. Zach Nelson gives to Jackson Bell. That keeps North running. It's only been 3 years since they won it all. You remember 2016. Charlie Bell and the Hawks prove they're good away from home. They could be good in the playoffs, too, tonight. It's a 65-53 final score. Let's go to Missouri, where the playoffs are nearly here in the Show Me State, too. Good luck to just about anybody facing Rockhurst. The Hawklets have 4 state championships, but none since 2013, which means they might be due for another one. Welcome to Jeff City. The Jays drove 2.5 hours to meet the Rock, which seeks win number 20. Shuttle ahead to the second half. The Hawklets lead by double figs. Glenn McClintock with the one-hander and the hack. Hawklets go up by 23. Wow. More Rock, more McClintock. The double team can't stop him. He sets up Marcus Tehan for 3. 51-24. Rockhurst owning the thing on State Line Road. Still in the third, it is Mason Dillon with a pass from McClintock. Pretty good effort for the hometown guys on State Line. It is an easy victory at home. Jeff City takes it on the chin, 69-29. Finally, Blue Springs South 7-game win streak was snapped on Tuesday. Jalen and the Jags hope to begin anew, welcoming in Lee Summit West. Titans batting first in this one. Noah Kinder penetrates and kicks. Tyson Brennan makes it stick. Lee Summit West has the early advantage. South is strong for sure. Check out McDaniel. Jalen McDaniel. We talk about him a lot. He is a 10th grader, but he is powering the Jaguars in this one. Johnny George looking pretty darn good as well. Dancing at the Triple Rock. There's a nice lay-in as well. And Blue Springs South pounces on another victory on their home court tonight. You want scores? We'll give you scores, including pretty good win. Congrats, Center Yellow Jackets. That's a nice 1-point victory.